On the crime watch, a judge has suspended the prosecution of a man charged with killing his mother after he was found mentally incompetent. 29-year-old Christopher Sorensen, is charged with the bludgeoning death of his mother, 71-year-old Janet Sorensen. Happened back in December. Sorensen was found fit to stand trial on his first evaluation, on the second one, found incompetent. The judge ordered another evaluation, which he'll review before deciding on March 6th if Sorensen is competent to stand trial. Meantime, he'll stay in custody at the Monterey County Jail.
An alert going out tonight in Santa Cruz for the public to be on the lookout for two men who police say are wanted criminals and could be dangerous. They are Justin Gorman and Nicholas Bose. Bose is a parolee at large who has been convicted of burglary, vehicle theft, and drug possession. Police say he's addicted to meth and is in a white supremacy gang. Gorman has an extensive criminal history that includes theft of an on-duty patrol vehicle, drug sales, and burglary.
Because of the measures that they've both gone through to avoid law enforcement, Buse has run from the police multiple times. Gorman has run from the police in very reckless pursuits before and has also produced a knife while struggling with officers. So we do consider him to be armed and dangerous.
Meantime, these two women who walked away from the Blaine Street Minimum Security Detention Center in Santa Cruz, they are back in custody tonight. Brittany Bose and Sarah Marco were arrested Friday. They're now being held in the Santa Cruz County Jail and facing new charges.
We have new information tonight on a former Hartnell College student convicted of killing his brother back in 2007. Today, Langston Williams was taken back into custody in Monterey County. The district attorney says the 25-year-old was caught trying to leave Texas, which is a violation of his probation. He was arrested in Texas last month trying to board a flight to Atlanta. Action News learned today he'll serve 20 days in the county jail for his probation violation. He had served nearly a year for the unintentional killing of his brother during an argument and is scheduled to be back in court on the 28th.